Hi, AT from CNC at Home. I want to pick up where we left off last time. We were dealing with burning tiles and there was something odd happening. I've gone through and I've cleaned the lens, I've refocused, and not sure if that helped or not. What I've done is I've created some test tiles where I just took some, I've got six white tiles and I painted them. Two of the tiles I painted with the primer paint. Two of the tiles I painted with the paint and primer. And two more tiles with just the primer paint. I'll get to those in a second. The first two tiles, one with primer, one with paint and primer, I did a light coat. What I'm trying to test is the thickness of the coat of paint I'm putting on to see if that has affected my burn parameters. So I put a light coat on. And the next set, again, one primer, one paint and primer. When I say paint and primer, that's actual one can. It's called paint and primer. I put on a thicker coat. No. With the second set of tiles, what I did was I did one tile primer, one paint and primer, but I did two coats on each. So I did a light coat, and then I let that cure for a while, and then I came back and did a second coat on there. Now, the other two tiles that I was talking about are both primer, and what I did with those is I painted those like I normally do. I go back and forth, get a coat on, and then I go 90 degrees to that and get but not a second coat, but right on that first coat, get nice good coverage, and then let those dry. On those, I did a similar pattern to what I'm doing on these first four. Let's talk about those first four real quickly. I'll throw that up here on the side. How about? I did a real basic gradiated pattern, and I'm trying it at two different burn speeds and two different resolutions, for not having a better word. One of those I did at 350 dots per inch, if you want to call it that, and then the other one I did at, I forget what the number is, but it's equivalent to 0.1 millimeters per line. So there's basically 10 lines per millimeter, if that makes sense. The 350 lines per inch translates to 0.073 millimeters per line, so we get more of those. So I wanted to see if the resolution and the speed were having any effect on there, along with the thickness of the coat of paint. So that's the first four tiles, and we'll take a look at those. The last two tiles was a different experiment. I put a coating on there like I normally have in the past, and then I did four gradiated patterns again. This time I did number of passes. So I used my normal feed speed, normal power, used Jarvis dithering on this, so it was 1200 millimeters per minute at 85% power with my 5.5 watt laser, and did these gradiated patterns. The first one on the left is just one pass, the next one is two passes, then three passes, and four passes on the last one. Then I came back and I changed the speed. So I upped it, basically doubled it. I went to 2400 millimeters per minute at 85% power and did the same gradiated pattern. One pass, two pass, three pass, four pass. So those are the six different tiles. The results were interesting, to say the least. So let's take a look at those. I will show the burning process. I'm not going to show the painting process because I've shown that in several other videos. We'll just go right to the burning process, and then I will show each of the tiles how they turned out after they were cleaned up, and we can talk about what's going on there. Let's go look at the burn process real quick and then the final results. This first tile is the primer paint, and I put a thin coat on this and it really was too thin. That showed up in the burn. So I needed more paint just for that base coat. This is the paint and primer version of this. Everything else is exactly the same. This one turned out much better. The layer of paint was a bit thin. We'll see that once it's cleaned up.
Now we're moving to the two coats of paint. This is the primer. Again, that first layer of paint was really thin, so the second layer made it almost like a normal layer. Again, we'll look at these when they're cleaned up. And finally, we have two coats of the primer paint, or the paint primer. And this one we'll see turned out really bad. It looks good here, but there was just too much paint. It was too thick. Now we can really see how poorly this turned out. This is where it was just too thin of a layer of paint. This is the paint primer where I put more of a normal one on. That worked out okay. This is the two layers of primer. This is about the thickness it should have been initially. And here's what it looks like when I did the two layers that was just too thick. Virtually nothing came through on this. Looking over on the left, we can see that the best results were from the primer when I had about the right thickness on there. The regular paint thickness, it was a little light, so it didn't come out as well as it should have. Here we have the number of pass tests. And that first, just one pass at our normal settings, turned out the best. What this experiment has really shown me is it's very important to get the right amount of paint on the tile before you start burning and then using your default settings. Multiple passes just made more black, and when we're doing this process, we do need white still. The big takeaway here is put the right amount of paint on the tile and use your default settings.
Okay, here's our two tiles. As we can see, using our normal cutting parameters or burning parameters with the right amount of paint really worked well. This is doing it twice as fast. I was thinking maybe we could get something happening over here with multiple passes. It didn't work. It was a great experiment, and now I know that multiple passes with this doesn't really help. So our big takeaway, too dark. We didn't end up with any white down here, so multiple passes just makes it worse with the right amount of paint. With the right amount of paint and the right burning parameters, and here's the burning parameters on this one, it was 1200 millimeters per minute at 85% power, and the lines per millimeter was set just shy of the 0.1. It's the 0.085, which is like 300, I think, lines per inch. There's two settings in light burn, so you can use either one. Anyway, that's the default settings that I have for tiles, and it turned out really well. So that was a good experiment. It lets me know that the laser is working correctly and the process is working correctly. I just had something not quite set up right. I don't know. I still have not figured out how I got that ghosting image. So that's going to require some more experimenting to see if I can duplicate that again. That would be a really cool process if I could figure out what it was that made that happen. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Hit the thumbs up, the like, whatever it is here on YouTube. That really helps out a lot. And if you like the content that we do here at CNC at Home, please think about subscribing. It goes into the YouTube analytics, statistics, all sorts of weird stuff. It promotes the videos, and the more watches and likes that we get, the better the channel does. The better channel does, the better content that we're going to be able to put out here. So thank you for watching, and have fun doing your CNC at home projects. Oops.